What's up, y'all? It's your boy Dripstar Jam. We down here at week game two of the Fat Boy Basketball League. Today we got the Music City Cavs versus the 615 Bulls. Hey man, the Music City Cavs had a great game last week, and the 615 Bulls are struggling. They have a record of 0-2, so looking forward to get their first win of the season. With the 615 Bulls, our starting five is WAP, number 50. We got Tay, Fat Living, World, who is our starting point guard. He was pretty mad about coming off the bench last week, but he got a start, so we're going to see what he do. And we got G out there, my boy G, you know, representing for the short guy committee. Shout out to you, man. Starting off, we got Umar J throwing it to baby G with a quick steal. Fat 5 Bulls coming out strong. Shout out to the Music City Cavaliers. They got that boy Caveman out there. He was holding it down for him last week when the bench was a little short. Got that boy Dre bringing it up court, passing it out to Nyjah. And Umar J over there, of course, and baby G. As they commit a turnover, 615 Bulls looking to score again. World with the first three, trying to get warmed up. I actually seen him this week at Hadley Park Community Center in the basketball gym. So he definitely be practicing, y'all. This ain't the only time he be hooping. Fat Living coming down fast with a nice pass to G, but he does not get it. I think it rolled off one of the Music City Cavaliers' feet. Fat Living is so essential for this group. He keeps the pace up. It seems like he's always moving at the same pace, whether they're losing, whether they're winning, whether he scores or if he passing. I love his energy. I think he's a great asset to this team as he does a no-look pass to WAP. WAP misses the floater. Nyjah kind of wild with it. Ah, they call a foul. I don't know if I like that. We got Caveman who throws it up also, but it does not count. They called a foul before that. So they are looking for the Music City Cavaliers to take it out. A thrilling game last game. Looking forward to the same vibes as Umar J hits the first three of the game. You know, that's his game too, man. That's what he do. He out here to shoot threes, nothing else. World doing unworldly things with the basketball. Caveman with the shot. My boy Caveman, bro, he got great energy. And like I said, he pretty solid. He held him down last week, but I want some of them shots to fall for him. Nip with the three, on the back of his jersey. Not playing no games, coming out hot with the six for the 615 Bulls. Caveman passing it to Dre. He takes it into traffic. I don't know why. Did they call it? What they call for that? Very risky move to go into traffic like that. They are lucky to get the ball back. It must have been a kickball. Got your boy Day-Day over here stretching, ready to check in. He steps out of bounds. Umar J with them big feet. Slow it down, my brother. 615 Bulls get another chance. You got World taking it out. Say he need a rest. He don't need to be taking nothing up court. He's supposed to be starting point guard. After what he just did, man, that one. Look at him. Oh my God, he about to come to the bench. Dre with a fast break lay, he makes it. World is about to come. He's about to come sit over here by me. If he mess up one more time, he can put his good shoes on. I need you to do some good moves. Oh my God, another turnover from World. Coach is looking through these shades like, boy, you just don't know if he wasn't my OG, you'd be over here right now. World had a lot to say, like I said last week, about coming off the bench, and I don't know if you're ready for that, my guy. Please don't beat me up next week or whenever you see this. I'm just, you know, staying facts, my guy. Shout out to you, OG. Caveman passes it to Umar J for the three. Almost rolls in, but it doesn't. Fat Living swings it to Tay. Tay moving. Oh, swings it unselfishly. WAP loses the ball. Nip fighting hard down there for that ball, as we do, as the short kings do. We do not play. You know, he's a little closer down there to the ground, so he was able to get that ball. The 615 Bulls call a timeout. as they talk some things over, it just kind of look a little loose over there. We're late to the huddle, and Coach looked at World and said, "Hey, you're starting point guard. You can't be giving the ball up," and that is true. Music City Cavaliers getting off to a pretty solid start, not really making a whole lot of noise, just kind of getting some easy points. Looking forward to Dre taking over Umar J to continue shooting these threes. Caveman, like I said, I want to see some of these going for you, but you gotta find your spot on the floor. Find your good shot. Stop trying to take these, you know, shots that you don't be working on, bro. You gotta get the easy ones. That's what they need you for, and that good defense. Who is that? Baby G, bro. I expect a lot more from you too, man. You're the biggest dude out there on the court. Part of the Twin Towers. Need you to be more enforceful on defense and a factor in the paint on offense. They got some little guys in there right now for 615 Bulls, so y'all got to take advantage while y'all can. It's a big boy league. Inbound, Nip passes it to Tay. Tay looking comfortable out there today. Looked like he was a little ready. As he turns it over, I guess he wasn't. Nip ready to take the ball as he alters the fast break. Three from Caveman almost off the back rim. I like that shot. Not a bad shot. One thing Caveman gonna do, he gonna put that body on you for that defense, man. He get that light skin treatment, they don't be calling it. World asking for the ball, dribbling it in. Oh my God, World have mercy. World, boy, you 2 seconds off the bench. Oh yeah, Coach calling in a sub now. Come on. Oh, who they take off? Fat Living says, I can't even do nothing because they keep turning the ball over. I feel you, bro. You know, World got that thing going on where, you know, he can't look to the left, can't even look the coach in the eyes because he know he wrong. But I'm going to get off the OG. We back here. The score is 5-5. Not too many baskets went in, but a whole lot of motion. Derek out here. Oh, my boy got some, he got some team shorts today. Dre with the no-look pass in the paint. To a big baby. That's what we need. He gets him an easy bucket. I think he needs to at least have 8 more of those easy lays. World is passing it to Tay. Tay with the 3. He makes it all net. Shout out to that boy, Tay. The son. Day-Day liking what he sees from his son over here. Looking forward to seeing them both on the court at the same time. My Jay lets it go. He does not. Pretty tall guy, but I guess it was still out of his reach. Will bringing it up court. Will, if he turns it over again, okay, he makes a smart pass to Tay. He in the corner. Pumps fake. Nice dish inside. Wop goes up and makes the easy layup. That's how you play, team. The score is 10-7. 615 Bulls trying to keep the lead. So they can get their first W of the season. Derek bringing it up. Wow. Passes it to Dre on the right wing. Derek is confusing us all. I don't know what he's trying to do. Umar J with his famous shot and gets the lucky shooter's bounce, man. A 3. The score is now tied 10-10. Watt bringing it in with those good old natural plant socks he got on. The 615 Bulls are a little all over the place as Steph Banz comes in, gets swatted by Big Baby G. Caveman bringing it down court. He gets one. Easy lay. That is your game, my boy. I like those fast break. You're one of the smallest people on the court. Get out fast and transition, and you could probably have a couple more of those. Nip bringing it in, pass it to World. World with the 3 makes up for all of the unworldly things he was doing before. The 615 Bulls still in the league, up 1, 13-12. I think our coach, our Music City Cavaliers coach, he actually was frying our fish out there. I hope he I'll be going to go back out there and check on that for us. As Umar J makes another three, I think he's more worried about frying the 615 Bulls than our fish over here. But we're going to get it anyway. They are going back and forth. Tay with a three as he airballs. Umar J, I feel like he's going to go coast to coast with this. I don't think he's looking to pass. Okay, pass it to K-Man. Good ball movement. Baby G. Big Baby with a three. He misses. Caveman smoking on this good Sunday. World. Oh, my God. World with the worldly. Oh, almost made it. Hey, look like World trying to get back in this thing. OG, I see you. Umar J missing these shots that he normally makes. Some great competition going on. Fat Living and Day-Day checks back in. Shout out to Day-Day, one of the founders of Fat Boy Basketball League. Love to see you guys get out there. I said, Day-Day, I need two threes out. He said, I got your five. That's what he said. So can't wait to see at least one of them go down. Steph Bands, very active last week. Had a great game. Day-Day with the three. Oh, my God. What happened to Virgil? Wap with the secure rebound off the air ball and goes back up and makes the easy lay. Derek bringing it down. He said, I don't want no nickname on the back of my jersey. Just call me Derek. And he definitely hoops like a Derek. He just be telling everybody what to do, man. I love it, man. Umar J taking it in. Something unique for him. Like I said, not really his game. He's usually on that perimeter shooting threes, burning people's eyebrows off. I believe that was the first half. Yeah, that was the first quarter. What a great first quarter. The score is tied 15-15. We're going to take a quick break here. We'll be right back with the second quarter. Great basketball, great food, good vibes. Fat Boy Basketball League.
Sensible Oils, located at 3921 Clarksville Pike inside the Harris Plaza, carries the finest fragrance oils for men and women.
Did you know you can mix any fragrance into a lotion, shower gel, or body mist to match your favorite fragrance?
Not to mention we have the best whipped shea butter in the city.
Don't forget about our scented candles that will burn up to 80 hours of pure aromatherapy.
Come check us out. Sensible Oils, located at 3921 Clarksville Pike inside the Harris Plaza.
What's going on, y'all? It's your boy Tripstar Jam. We are back here at the Fat Boy Basketball League. Week 3, Game 2, 615 Bulls versus Music City Cavaliers. Hey, it started off to a great start, 15-15. Game is tied. Three is going back and forth. Steph Bands takes it in and air balls. Looked like a travel there. World over here says, Steph, you got to make that pass. Maybe he should have. The coach said, you can't be talking, bro. You passed it to the other team five times already. Derek brings it up court. Umar J looks to shoot. It's very confusing because, you know, his game is a little unorthodox. He's usually on the perimeter, but he's been taking it in the last couple possessions. He's like a Jokic a little bit. It's like, whoa, what is going on here? They just let him straight through the paint, but he could not finish. World says, again, he got a lot of input on this game. He says that the ball is a little slippery. It ain't true for missing that layup. I don't know. I think it's both of y'all. But anyway, once again, we're still here. Second quarter, 15-15. Drake takes the ball. Number 77 is an odd number for basketball. I wonder where he got that number from. Wow, a three from Big Baby. I was not expecting that. Must be some haters in the room. They ain't make a lot of noise for that. And shout out to you. I think he has 5 points in the first half already. Tay sizing up Derek. Oh, my. Hey, I would have blew past him yesterday. Nice. Ooh, almost in and out. Gets his own rebound. Shoots the mid-range. He's feeling it, and he makes it. Good shot, Tay, a.k.a. Dead Sun. Umaje staring everybody down as he comes up the court. Derek doing his famous head above the ball look around. Nice dish to Niger, but he smokes it. Got to make those, Niger. You don't really touch the ball a lot. When they give you the ball, I think they're expecting for you to make a move. So, got to make those. Got to make those. Touch your shot and always be ready. Always be ready. Steph Banz looking to get on the board as he brings it up. Swings it to Nip. Nip bringing it into. Tay telling somebody come send me a pick. I believe it was 3 seconds in the paint on Fat Living. The coach is the, like I said, man. Oh, that boy Caveman off the backboard. Nice bank shot, mid-range. Shout out to you, bro. Getting them light-skinned buckets in. I see you, my guy. Fat Living with the three. He said he's sick and tired of being tied. Nice three. Fat Living. 615 Bulls, they are hanging in, man. Looking to get a W today. Caveman shooting a three, feeling it, feeling good. I'm not mad at that three. Fat Living bringing it all the way up, passing it crazy, giving it to Steph Banz. Steph Banz shooting a wild shot. Rico Soul, we might need you back in here, man. Steph Banz is not Steph Banz and from like he was last week. Steph Banz, when you hear this, bro, I don't want no smoke. I'm just telling what it is. Tay presses Umaje on the floor. What? Wow, forces the double dribble. We still got some skin from Tay's knee on the floor as we speak. Tay is moving pretty quick today. Every game it seems like he gets a little bit more comfortable out here. Fat Living with another three. Misses it hard off the front rim. Nip thinks about it, but no, if he rolls into them bleachers, that head going to be stuck in there. Pause. The score is still tied, 20-20. Not a lot of noise from Dre, but he is really sneaky. Once he gets going, kind of hard to stop him. And Tay got his fingers wiggling at him. He like, I wish you would. As Dre pulls it. And he does, but he hits hard off the back rim. We got Day-Day passing it to the Sun. Oh, Fat Living running fast. Wow, he's, man, passes it back to him. Three in the corner. He fouled him. And he hits the side of the backboard. Wildin'. I think we all just need to have a reset, man. It's a whole lot of bodies moving, but not a lot of points going in. Got Day-Day coming back out. As who goes in? I think WAP is back in for Day-Day. Umaje has a little guy on him. Spins, shoots, and misses. Would have been nice if he had it. Look at Caveman on those boards battling with Fat Living, but cannot finish. It is the 615 Bulls. Ooh-wee. That fish smelling and looking good. I did. What happened? Oh, my God. They are eating my fish. But anyway, we are here. Nip with the three. Quick release, and he makes it. Quick with the draw and ain't missing. I love it. Good shot from Nip. It's a Fat Boys League, man. I don't know how you made it in here, but you did. A triple double team, and he still makes it. Great shot as he runs back on defense. The score is 23-22. Tay with the confident three off the backboard. Like I said, he's gotten a lot more comfortable in these last two games. Shot it excellently on somebody, shooting their eyebrows off. When they go to timeout, I'm going to tell Coach to bring me some hot sauce. But a hard miss off the back rim. Fat Living taking it in strong. You're doing too much, my brother. Dunk it next time if you're going to get that high. Caveman throws it easy. That is your game, bro. That's your game, bro. Keep doing that, and y'all going to have a chance to win. Caveman very active as Fat Living. Fat Living said he's too small, though. I can do that all day. I can do that all day. I would like to see one of the bigger guys guard Fat Living. I don't know if Caveman is the solution. Got to be ready for those passes. Tay going on the slow break. Gets fouled, it looks like, but they didn't call anything. Steph Band's there to clean that up. 2 minutes left. The score is 24-30. 615 Bulls have taken off. Kept a pretty good lead in this game. Good momentum going on. They doing some coaching over here. We love to see a player coach, man. Nothing like that. To have a guy on the sideline and on the court. You know what I'm saying? Keeping these players' spirits lifted up. Keep them motivated. And, man, these guys look serious out here, man. The Music City Cavaliers look winded. I don't know what they ate this week, but they don't look like they're going to be able to pull through, man. But it's a whole lot of basketball left. Hopefully they'll find their win. Maybe they need a piece of fish or something. You know, get them through this. It's your boy, Dripstar Jam. Once again, I just talked to one of the players, man. I am a fitness instructor, fitness coach. I will get you in shape. I will get you in shape. But just talk to one of the players. We're definitely finna do a program. Get this conditioning right, man. Because it's a long season, and it's a long game. As you hear in the background, they got $10 t-shirts down here. Got good food, good fish outside. Make sure if you're listening to us and you are in the city, pull up on us down here at Brick Church Middle School. Dre throws it in to a double team. I don't know if I would have did that. Dre a little quiet in this first half. Definitely looking for him to spark. Big Baby at the line. I apologize. He is not at the line. They will be passing it in. A quick foul. I haven't seen him before. Number 24. My first time seeing him be fouling. Already giving me Black Air Force energy. Number 24 with the name Mamba. Expecting a lot from you with that name and that number, sir. Nigel with the first free throw. Bricks it hard off the back. Oh, my God.
Diz ate the fries?
No, they wasn't ready.
Oh. World, as he chased down the ball, Music City Cavs still remain possession. Dre with double team. So I think we have a foul. Big Baby at the line again. For sure. The coach says that they are calling every call on the 615 Bulls, but the 615 Bulls cannot get a call. That is a message from the coach. He's right here in our view at the bottom of the screen. He feels that the refs is playing unfair. Somebody got money. Somebody just slipped the refs some money. You know what? I wouldn't be surprised if Coach from the Music City Cavaliers slipped him a 20 or something. He keep a little 20 in his pocket. Big Baby with the free throw again makes that one. One for two from the line. Steph Bands, as he loosens up that do-rag, looking to get into this game. Wow. Derek tries to draw the charge. Steph Banz misses. Dre taking it on the slow break. As he Euro steps through that lane and misses it. Day-Day chasing down the ball, about to run out the gym. My God. Day-Day, you need some breaks. Need some new breaks, Day-Day. Love the hustle, love the passion from these players, man. Nothing like it. Like I said, these guys, they definitely play like this means something to them. And that's why I love being here. Sneaky pass to Umar J from the other Twin Tower, Big Baby. I think if those two connect, they got a good chance in this game. If they get their own two-way game going, that's a good dynamic duo right there. Wap taking it in. Misses, almost makes it, but almost is never enough. Derek, as he's sizing up the defense, passes it to Big Baby. Umar J with the double team. Swings it to Caveman, the mid-range, hard off the back rim. Wap still feels like that defense ain't nothing. But apparently it is, because he can't get nothing off in that paint right now. A little over 50 seconds left in this second quarter. Will the 615 Bulls keep the lead going into the second half? Got Nip about to check back in. Mamba out there has not been doing any Mamba-esque things. Looking to see him get a little comfortable out here, but he actually is coming to get comfortable on the bench right now. Oh, no, he was taking it out. My bad. Let's see if he can get some motion in Ocean World, not knowing if he wants to shoot, but he got some hang time, so he had a choice. Fat Living smokes the layup. World is everywhere. He an OG, but he moving like a youngin. I see you, OG. Umar J is trying to run down some of this clock. But they are at a deficit of 3 points. They need to make a big shot to have some confidence going into this next half. In and out, shot. Three ball from Umar J. Hey, man, if I've never seen that before, that's what he does. And this was a great first quarter, 30-30. This is the second game. Both games have been tight. We're going to take a brief break. We're going to go into halftime. Stay tuned. If you can get down here, come on down here. If you can't, stay locked in. We'll be right back with Fat Boy Basketball.
We're back. Guys, we're back. We're back. It was Friday. 6 to 10 p.m. We know how we got food trucks, dinner, live band, raffle, you name it. This is the place you can be every first Friday. Make sure you record.
put your mic down. What's going on? It's your boy Dripstar Jam. I am here, down here at the Fat Boy Basketball League. It is week 3, game 2. Pretty intense game. I'm here with one of the referees, AP. How you feeling today?
I'm feeling good, man. Just good to be around the game.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah.
So this is your second game here. This is your first time reffing at the Fat Boy Basketball League?
Yes.
What can you say has been different just about the style of basketball and the play here than anywhere else?
I think the style is similar. I think the difference is the tenacious defense. Like, they really taking it serious.
Yeah.
Even because they're a heavier group, it doesn't really matter, but they're still tenacious.
Yeah, anything, is that what surprised you? I was going to ask you, did anything surprise you?
What surprised me is their aggression as well. Like, in terms of going up, they want to feel the game. They love the
yeah.
game. You can see it. Yeah.
Yeah, it's definitely a whole lot of passion in it. Appreciate you. Where do you usually ref at?
I usually ref for AAU games, and then She Got Game League sometimes. Yeah.
That's what's up. Shout out to you, man. Great meeting you. And we about to get back to this game. So good luck out there and stay safe.
All right, for sure. Thank you.
All right, for sure.
Thank you.
So, like I said, we are back here. It is the third quarter of the Music City Cavaliers versus the 615 Bulls game. Whole lot of intensity going on, as Ref AP stated. A whole lot of bodies clashing at each other, and super excited to just get back into it, man. The score is tied with a late three-pointer from Umar J to tie it up at the end. Both of the coaches were yelling at their teammates, pretty much like not really satisfied with the gameplay. They feel like, regardless of whatever the ref says, there's so much better that each player can do. So we are already back in here. We got a pass. Wow, they caught a block on that. A deep pass from Derek to Naja as he gets blocked but also fouled from WAP. So Naja will go to the line for a shooting free throw. One of the keys to the game is to play defense on. One of the keys to the games from the 615 Bulls is to play defense on their three-point shooters. So that means that Umar J cannot get these wide-open threes. Dre does not need to be woken up for his threes. And I think they'll be all right. A lot going on down there, but not a lot of buckets going in. 615 Bulls ball. Steph Banz, looking for him to get into this game. He's had a rough start to this first half. It is not a second half, so looking to see him get involved. Got Nip passing it back to Tay. They both have had a solid first half, too. Tay taking it in strong. Fat Living, a little foul. The coach puts his hand out like, wow, you ain't going to call that one either, huh? But like Ref AP said, she's trying to let them play a little bit. You know, they all kind of just moving wild in there at times. So, you know, big boys going to do what big boys do. We got WAP at the line looking to make a pair of free throws. First one is in there with the lucky shooter's bounce. Will he make number two? Let's see. Someone yells from the sideline and he smokes it. Derek bringing it up court. I really love how you can see his team trusts him. They let him bring it up court. Uh-oh. Snip with the easy steal. Dre's head is just not in the game. Tay does not go up for the easy layup. Takes the three just like a young person would and makes it. I guess his coach isn't too mad about that. The score is 34-30. They are double-teaming Dre. Like I said, Dre has not had a good game, but that doesn't mean that he can't. A three from Big Baby, he makes it. Once again, quiets the crowd. I don't know if this is it's kind of seeming like a 615 Bulls home game a little bit. Tay passes it to Steph Banz. Steph Banz looking to get a tween, but pass it back to the hot man. Nip with the three. Hard off the back rim. Got Derek bringing it up court, passes it, but cannot get it through there as Steph Banz broke it up, coming down with the smooth pass. Wow, nice reverse finish from WAP. These guys is balling today, y'all. Score is 36-33. Oh! Know what I'm saying? Making sure that camera right. Nice defense. Hey, oh, Nip was not paying attention. So, Fat Living yells at him, saying, bro, you wide open. But you know what? That's my fault. That's my fault. It's both of their fault, though, because Nip wasn't paying attention, and Fat Will even passed it to him without him paying attention. Dre is getting shut down by Steph Banz, it seems like. Pass it to the corner. Another three from Big Baby. Man, he must have heard me over here talking because he's had a great game. I was expecting him to have more points in the paint, but he is hot from the three today. Tay bringing it up court, who has not been bad from the three itself. Shooting almost makes it, but as I said, oh, Fat Living draws the foul. He still got them ones on, man. He must have not heard me and Joe talking about him, so I ain't going to say nothing else. You know, he do what he do. He do his thing out here. He's looking to make a pair of free throws, and I got money that he makes them. He's a pretty focused player, and he got some goggles on, so he should be able to see pretty well. Ah, he misses the first one. Shout out to Coach from the Music City Cavaliers, man. This fish was good. Was good, man. I can't believe you, man. How do you manage a game and get the fish out hot, man? You something else. Fat Living misses both free throws. Dre passing it out to Big Baby as he is on a run but misses. Fat Living runs into Dre. They call a quick foul. I'm over here being a fat boy right now, munching on some fries. I'm going to put them down and get back to this game. The score is tied up 36-36. 4.5 seconds left in the third quarter. Tay bringing it up. Pass it to Steph Banz. I don't think he was ready for it. Gives it to WAP. What a wild shot. I don't know if I would have shot that if I was him. Gets a second chance. Underhand. What in the WAP was that? Dre is just not. Oh, that's Umar J. I apologize. So, 615 Bulls have been pretty good on defense today. That was one of their keys to the game, was to be strong on defense. And I think they've done just that. They got to keep it up, though. The game is tied, so they got to get more points and let less buckets go in for the other team. Nip is guarding Dre pretty tight. Oh, Dre falls. I do not know what's going on with Dre today, man, but this is unlike him. The bench is pretty scarce for the Music City Cavaliers. It doesn't look like they have too many other options, but I really feel like they got what they need to have on their teammate. Nip with another three. It's too much to the left. Here's the back rim. It looks like everybody got some of this fried fish out here, man. It's something about it. It's nothing like fried fish on a Sunday, though, I'll tell you that. Whistles just have been blowing all day. These refs is not playing. So we go, and we're going to figure out a rhythm, you know, as the season goes on. You know, we had last week where we went minutes without a whistle being blown to now they calling everything. AP said something to me, but I don't hear it. Steph Banz with the three. I know that must feel good. Finally gets on the board. Score is 39-36, keeping the 615 Bulls ahead. Wow. The referees called jump ball, but Steph Banz really got it out the mud that time. Me personally, I think that was a steal, but I'm just a commentator. I don't call the shots here. But they end up giving it to the 615 Bulls. I really got to get a grasp on how this jump ball thing's going. Steph Banz gets the inbound. Got Mamba back out there looking for him to do some Mamba things. Tay shooting that ball, man. Getting it in. He has to have at least 8 points, 8 to 10 points by now. Dre passes it to Nyjah. Got a mouse in the house. Caveman. Hey, oh, my God. Mamba slaps his own teammate. That's my Black Air Force player of the game already. I'm giving it to Mamba just for slapping your own teammate in the face. I didn't do a Black Air Force player last game, but that is a foul. The ref did not call that. Wow. Nice. Unselfish pass from Fat Living to Nip, letting the short king get his shine. We got a timeout over here. We got a timeout from the Music City Cavaliers, man. Hey, coach is not pleased. The score was just tied at 36-36. Now it is 36-43. 615 Bulls looking to get their first W of the season. So shout out to them. Also, shout out to MOC Studio for making this live stream happen. Got you all the views, all the inside footage, even the audio coming through. They work hard and are great what they do. And also shout out to Day Day and Trap for making this event a weekly thing, an annual thing. It's growing. It's such a good thing. And also, as you see those commercials that go on in between the breaks, that could be you. That could be your business. That could be anything that you have to offer. We are looking to fill up some slots, so make sure you reach out to MLC Studio or Trap or Day Day and get your business in there. We would love to see it and love to work with you. All about supporting businesses around here. As we come out of this break for a timeout, we have World checking back in for Tay. And Derek is still sitting on the side getting a little break in. Caveman throws it up to Big Baby. Gilbert gets the and one. No look finish on the layup. The coach from Music City Cavaliers is loving that. I've got a pretty good grasp on the players' names. I got to do a little bit better with getting these coaches' names. Big Baby at the line, having a pretty good game. Will he make the first one? Well, that's the only one because it's an and one, and he does make that. Nip with a three, not thinking about it. Probably should have. Caveman. Discombobulated up the court. Once again, a silent game from Dre. As this quarter comes to an end, looking to see if he, you know, can pull something out of his hat at the at the end of the game. 4 seconds left here. Steph Banz bringing it back with some defense. Almost makes the three. He does not get the foul call. As you see the coach with his hands up, not getting any calls that he wants. And I'm sure Steph Banz wanted that as well. We are here, man. We are going to the fourth quarter at Brick Church Middle School Fat Boy Basketball League. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, it will be fourth quarter. It's a show to see. We'll be right back.
For the ultimate wing experience in Music City, look no further than Strikeout Wings. With our mouth-watering $8.99 every day but Tuesday lunch specials, your midday cravings are sorted. But hold your appetite for Tuesday. Dive into our incredible 69-cent wing specials. And guess what? The party never stops with our daily happy hour from 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. featuring buy one, get one drinks. Strikeout Wings, bringing flavor to Nashville one wing at a time.
We're back. Nashville Black Market is back every first Friday at the Nashville Farmers Market. 6 to 10 p.m., we know how it goes down. We got food trucks, vendors, live games, raffles, you name it. This is the place you want to be every first Friday. Make sure you pull up on us.
What's going on? It's your boy Dripstar Jam. We are back here at Fat Boy Basketball League. Game 2, Week 3, Music City Cavaliers versus the 615 Bulls. 615 Bulls up 43-39, looking to get their first W. We are in the first quarter. Tay playing very hard. Gets the deflection but cannot throw it in to his dad. So they finally get it in. Oh, Umajay with a skip and a hop. Music City Cavaliers. That boy almost traveled to Cleveland. But we got Mamba over there, my Black Air Force player of the day, inbounding it to Tay. Mamba, let's see something. He said he's giving it to the hot man. Tay shoots a crazy shot, but almost banked it. Dede back in as he guards Derek. Big Baby at the top of the key, passing it to Caveman. Wow. Nobody was on Caveman, but Dede kind of just snuck in between there somewhere. Look at this guy, head down, running into nothing. And, oh my God, the behind the back on work. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my J. Oh my God. He has done some pretty good things in this season already, but that might have been one of the best plays from him already. World looking for some get back, swings it out to Fat Living for the three, air balls the hell out that shot. Derek bringing it up with another ridiculous pass. That's not like him. Dede shoot. What is going on outside? Hey. We might need to take another break and try it all over again. Way too many turnovers as Coach Jazz, the coach, says, hey, man, way too many turnovers. And I agree. We ain't out here to see, you know, we trying to see some buckets go in. Fat Living at the line, looking to make a pair. Takes his time on it, still misses. You know, I would really love to see the matchup between him and AD Hasselman. That would be such a good matchup. I'm sure that would be coming at some point in the season. He misses both free throws, very unlikely of him, but I'm sure he'll get it back. Umajay. Feeling, oh my God, still crossing and saucing the league. As he makes another layup, he is not playing. Coach must have lit a, oh my God. Tay has so much knee skin on the court. It's crazy. But Jazz the coach must have lit a fire under Umajay. He has came out very aggressive in these last few possessions with the behind-the-back tween-tween swiggeroos going crazy, man. Shout out to you, Umajay. You definitely putting on for this league and the big boys, man. Keep doing what you're doing. The score is now tied, 43-43, out of nowhere. I don't even know how that happened. But Umajay has put the Music City Cavaliers on his back with the help of Derek. Najee playing some pretty tough defense. Derek fouling very ferociously. Putting that grown man forearm in Lil Tay chest. That was messed up, bro. Very OG of you. Derek would have had to see me about that one. Tay looking. Oh, wait. Wop with the three. Air balling. Oh, my gosh. It's getting pretty physical. I don't know, you know, if it's an accident or if it's on purpose. Steph Mann said he pushed him, but Jazz the coach feel like he a little flopping. I feel like it was a little bit of both. Tay looking to pass to World. World got them moves, but I don't know why he keep wanting to take it in there. You need to just some big boys in there. You just need to shoot your three, your mid-range, or pass the ball. Never mind, OG. I ain't even gonna do you like that. That headband's got you thinking that you Jordan. I don't know if you can. Anyway, we are at 43-43. It is tied. World has a chance to go up two at the line. Real smooth jumper. Makes the first one as he kicks that leg up. Caveman checks in as he gives Derek a breather. I love the effort from both of those guys today. They have been pretty solid. World, need you to make another one. Okay, I like that, man. You put a little sauce on the free throw. Cash Money Records. I like that. I like that. I like that. He looked over and said, yeah, talk about that. I got you. Umar J. I feel like, oh, my God. Hey, he's who? Oh, my God. Fat Living is. Oh, my God, bro. Umar J is hot right now. As Fat Living grabs his throat, like he got elbowed in the throat, but I don't know. I think WAP is playing prison ball, but it's going in. I like it, WAP. I ain't mad at you, bro. Get it how you live. Oh, my Jay still has the ball. Fat Living still wants some more. Oh, my God. He is twerking him. Nice. Nice. I said that 1-2 punch from the Twin Towers, man. I think if they keep doing that, they got a chance to be a force in this season. I think they need one more player on their team to kind of step up, and they'll be a pretty solid duo. As Fat Living answers back with a three of his own. Dre passes it to Nija, goes up. Tay fouls him pretty hard. So we will see Nija at the line. I feel like he got a little Black Air Force energy too, though. So that's my Black Air Force player for the Music City Cavs. Nice. Hey, but he's shooting like he got them white forces on, bro. That was sweet. That was a nice shot. Nija at the line. Nice crowd out here today at Brick Church Middle. Keeping it going. Wow, Nija with two. Those definitely are going to help out a lot. The score is 50-49. 615 Bulls still up. Steph Bans brings it up court. Not phased. Pass it to Fat Living. Steph Bans is doing a lot with the hook shot. Could not pull it in. Nija taking it in on Steph Bans with the spin. What? I feel like he got bailed out there. Got WAP over there. Strapping up that knee, looking to do some more bully ball. I see a lot of hands on their hips. I think that would be a nice logo for the Fat Boy League, Fat Boy Basketball League. They got their hands on their hands on their knees or hands on their hips, man. Nija with another free throw. He misses this one. Coach Jazz wish he could have had that. But I tell you what, Coach Jazz do got some good fish and fries. I am impressed.
I'm like, y'all need something from the store. I'm not going to go to the store because you take me out.
World says, he asked us if we need anything from the store. We need 2 threes from the store. That's what we need, World. World, give me 2 threes. That's what I need from the store.
I get free.
He said he cold, man.
I like it.
He said, yeah, shooting guard. I thought you wanted to run point. That ain't your thing? Yeah. Yeah. I am back into the game. Oh, the clock has not been moving. The clock is still at 2. Tay hits a 3 as we dispute the clock. They missed. They had a clock on standstill for about 20 seconds. As Tay says, it don't matter. I'm going to score anyway. Hits 2 threes. And the score is 53-49 as Cavaliers try to stay in this game. Big baby. Oh, man. Wow. WAP just got his hands up saying, hey, that's all D. Steph Bans has teammates on the interior, on the exterior, and still does not pass out. A very poor possession by the 615 Bulls, but they're probably feeling a little good because they're in the lead. But those are the kind of things that have them 0-2 right now. Big Baby misses the three. Over the back from WAP. Haven't seen that call all day. World looking to check himself in. Talking about Sub. The refs talk it over a little bit right there. It says, is over the back a call? No foul. Like I said, I haven't heard that call in a while, man. It's Fat Boy Basketball League, man. Ain't no over the back. Get it out the mud. So there is a dispute. The Music City Cavaliers is not letting it go. They said, not that easy. Coach is on the floor. That is a tech. Coach Jazz out there with fish grease spilling out his pores as we speak. And they're going to have to answer to that. Referee says it was no foul at all. The big boys are just going for the ball. The score is 53-49. 615 Bulls looking to take. They got a minute and 10 seconds left. So that call is very controversial if it goes into if it goes towards the Music City Cavaliers. They have a better shot of coming back. None of the Cavaliers are happy with that call. Right. Yeah. Coach feels like the guy is taking seniority here and saying that her whistle is invalid. Ref AP, stand on business, as the young people say. You need to stand on business about your call. They said, when I'm on the court, I'm a player, bro. Don't talk to me. I'm just out here trying to win. I ain't going to bend no rules for y'all. Wait a minute. I know. Oh, boy, I thought I lost my fish. Here we go. Score is 53-49. Tay running out a little clock here. As the 615 Bulls look to get their first win, he puts up a floater and makes it. That might have been a dagger. That might have put the nail in the coffin. That call definitely took a lot of energy out of the New City Cavaliers. Still a little time to do something with the ball. Big Baby with the three. Looks like if it were me, I would have probably shot that four-pointer. I haven't seen anybody shoot the four-point shots today. Fat Living tells him to just keep it up top, keep it slow. And I think they'll close it out right here. Umai J is coming to press with a quick foul, but I don't think the... Okay, does the clock stop? So I guess the clock does stop if it's a foul. Hey, man, it's a tough job to be a ref, but an even tougher job to be a ref at the Fatboy League Basketball, man. You got so much passion from the coaches, the players, the fans, the OG fans, the OG players. They got a pretty strong impact and inflect on this game. Nip is still playing. Dre brings it in and makes the layup. Score is 51-55. Not too much time. It looks like the 615 Bulls are going to take this here, man. And I can honestly say that the 615 Bulls have really got it out of the mud. They did not get a lot of calls that they wanted, but they made some really good shots. Kept the Twin Towers off the boards. And when they were not in their face, they was definitely making their threes. Got about 6 seconds left here. If they steal the ball and shoot a four-pointer, they might have a chance, but looks like that will be it. 1 second left. We got a dispute. They saying, hey, bro, when I'm hooping, Let me just hoop, man. You hey, but hey, they both players, man. So Tay shooting, missing the free throw. Man, this is so interesting, man. I love it down here at Fat Boy Basketball League. That is game. The 615 Bulls get the first W of their season. Shout out to Tay with a great game. Good threes. World. Started off a little rocky, but ended up getting some good passes. He said he's not much of a point guard, but I think he found his role later on. Nip, good work. Fat Living, doing what you do as always. Hey, Wop, what a great game playing that good old prison ball. Love to see it, man. We're going to take it to a quick break, and we got another game on our hands, man. I'm not going to tell y'all who it is, but just stay tuned. Y'all in for a good one. It's your boy Dripstar Jam. I'm out.